Crab finally back. Let's continue this grind in here. Alright, so I don't know exactly how strong I am or not am. Yeah, it's just try to do as much damage as possible. All right. Looks like it, pretty good. Honestly, I feel like Gao should be a mage as well, because his rage ability, it's not that reliable. If that's the case, then I guess I can change the equipment around a little bit. Switch it to The only issue then, though, is I have to learn Ultima. I mean, just take the growth egg off of him. And I'm just gonna give it to her for the time being. Because again, since I can't kind of choose exactly what I want to do with Gao when he goes into rage, it's better if I just learn magic, and then he can do damage that way. So I heard as well, slash read, that Phantom Dance is actually a magic attack. I'm not 100% sure on that. Yeah, if that's the case, I guess technically 7 should do a hybrid build. Probably gets attack up to I guess up to 80 or 90, but then also make sure he gets oh, that's right. Go ahead and used any thingamabobs yet. Oops. Oh, yeah, we might die actually, because I'm not well equipped for this. Oof. Right, 7. Show what you're made of. Ah, oh, they didn't kill him. Oh, I was lucky right there. Oh, I'm dead. Dang it. Okay. I forget that Ultima doesn't hit on both sides evenly, or it splits his damage in half if you're surrounded. It's kind of messed up there. So maybe Gao should be the one that wears the curse stuff. You can do Genji Glove. Just be very strong for a time. Ribbon. take out is pretty weak sauce. So weak. Nope, not happening. Now we gotta play this. I'm like, you know, getting wiped by the two Tyrannosaurs, let alone having to fight that guy. Oh, another guy. Here, let me try doing this. If Ultima does nines, then I'll keep trying. But if it doesn't, then yeah, it's no point. I should probably start doing Vanish, actually. Do I have Vanish? Oh, nope, we're dead. Never mind. Never mind. Yep. Thought so. Remember before when I was using the other party to grind, I didn't see one Brachiosaur for like probably 50 battles almost, but here I'm already getting him. What if there's like a trigger that causes him to appear more often? Oops, I forgot I have teleport on. Dang it. That's a waste. I must have saved after I encountered the first Brachiosaur that I teleport away from. Now thinking back, I should just have Gal be like the healer. Just have him keep casting Kiraga on everybody, or at least Kira on everybody, just so I can survive. Just in time to get some more strength. So we're doing Gao, Setzer, Mog. Those three are going to be pretty much support characters. More for healing. If I have to, I will, like, you know, attack. Honestly, though, I should probably not use, or get strength. I should probably get HP. Well, I guess I could still try to get, what should I call it? Still try to get, Ultima for Gao. You know, I won't use it all too much, but... much more for Ultima. Only 30%. Yeah, I think I should just learn that back at the other place. Shouldn't be wasting potential HP or some other stat boost. See, you learn Flare then. Of course, Flare not as nearly good as Ultima, but it'll do. Jump. Honestly, Gao should probably just sit here and defend. It's not really helping all that much. Behemoth suit's actually better. It's by barely any though, but Seven seems to have a lot of strength already. I'll do a couple more. He can be like the super powerhouse, like Cyan is. I was very low level compared to everybody else. Let's get it to like 80, maybe 90 actually, 90 magic. Oh nope, we are not doing this. Or are we? I mean, I just saved, so. Does it hurt to try? Too bad I can't like cast Protect on everybody, that'd be perfect. Does not kill everybody, but it does. Oh, it doesn't. Alright, Realm, you're just gonna have to push through and hopefully kill him. Nope, never mind. You're just gonna snort me out of here, huh? Alright, whatever. I guess that works. Wrecking gal right here. Actually, let's see how much auto attack he might do. He might do more than Phantom Dance. Not quite. Use this anymore. You can be using Zephyr Cloak. You can be using Growth Egg. This can be like 5 levels with Bahamut. Oh wow. Both used my meteor. I think Gao's dead. Alright. Seven ends up being the only survivor. He gets a buttload of experience though. Yeah, Gao's like woefully behind in levels. If I get Gao to like 50 magic even, probably perfect. I should probably switch her and Gao around, because Realm does need HP as well. I think I should also just have Hyper Wrist for Sabin, so at least he can have some defense so he doesn't die so fast. I do have a Hyper Wrist. What else can I do? Let me do this. Let me see something real quick. Down to 67. Attack of Fain Eyes it up to that. Which is add? Is this a percentage? So that's what 37. Yes, percentage for sure. It's probably a 25% boost. I thought it just gave a flat like 20 strength, but it gives way more than that. Let's give this guy the Zephyr. If I can find it. Zephyr Cape? Zephyr Cloak? So yeah, Hyper Wrist is really good. It gives a percentage of, I think 25% increase. Flare. He's gonna do the old switcheroo here. She can get Bahamut. So I still got what? 17 more levels with Realm in 7. So Realm's almost full power on Ultima. Let's check the 115. Let's gain two more levels with 7 for strength. Now I can move them to a different attribute. I think. Maybe speed. I think his stamina is pretty good, I would think, but I might be wrong. Seven. Let's go for the 120. Oh. Flare. Yeah, Gal's the one with the growth egg. Ouch. Jeez. We have no Osmos, huh? Darns. I feel like I should take myself to AP grinding spot real quick. Ooh, alright, let's go ahead and change it. What do I need? Stamina? How much stamina does Savin have? Pretty high already, 47. Let's get it up to like 55 or so. Try to beat this guy. Hopefully only hits on one of them, and you can't even get hit by it. I think I should be able to kill him, actually. Oh. What? Oh yeah, it's okay. Yeah. I think he dies. I hope. Oh no. Dang it. That was so close. I don't know how much damage I did to it, but it felt really close. Just had to do some stupid stuff. Let's see. Let me go to the other place real quick just to learn these moves. Maybe I just shouldn't care to stay here. Cause I don't need Osmos like right this second. It's because she's only spending one MP per cast. That's not bad. 4,000 something. Oh, didn't take any damage. Whoopsies. Pressing too many buttons. Yeah, that's just a weird place to put the retiring the title screen. It's like, why? I think it's like a level or two, and then I can stop using Bahamut for a realm. Almost done. Let me look at his stats here. 47 magic. Not too bad, actually. Realm 83. Let's try to get Gao to 55 magic. HP. What else we got? Guess I can bump up her stamina. His stamina is pretty good, 51. Not sure. Well, he can be on Bahamut. And she can be on Lakshmi for stamina. Eventually, I do need to use Osmos, but I'm gonna do it on a single T-Rex, not a double. It's a little dangerous to do so. Also needs to learn Osmos as well. Unfortunately, Gao's about to run out of MP, so he might have to go back to defending. Ouch. Holy crap. Wow. Jesus. Just give me a couple more levels, I'll be able to beat it. Oh, she's stuck on healing. Or is she doing Ultima? Ultima! Last level for magic. I can switch back to my strength. I should probably give the growth egg over to Sabin. Aw, oh, man. I was paying attention. How much more do I have for a Suva? A couple more. Let's go ahead and actually take the egg off of Gao. Fortress. I think this thing actually has 36,000. Oops. Forgot that he's doing haste. Yeesh. Alright. What were you learning? I was learning Ragnarok. I guess I can continue learning Ragnarok for the time being. I think I was also trying to learn or get back on strength for Gao. And probably get him to 55 or something like that too. Oh, I'm surprised he's out of mana. Because he had just enough mana to cast Meteor. A couple more levels of Bahamut on Sabin. crap. No, I wish I could like multicast. That'd be pretty cool. Ooh, got another one. Got another Celestia Triad. That means, yeah. There it is. Nice. If I can get one more, that'd be perfect. Definitely make grinding a lot easier because I can just single cast stuff. Oh, what? I mean, that's wrong. I can't really tell which one would, like, be stronger, Ultima or Meteor. I mean, you get pelted by, like, all these meteors. Oh, I've been, wasting stat buffs. I'm using Magma Rock right now. It's at 69. Yeah, if I can just double cast Ultima, then it's perfect. I'm still debating what else I should train Savin in. If not, just do more strength, or maybe just do speed. Crap. Either kills everybody, or we should have like a couple thousand left. Yeah, 2,000 remains. Can have a realm heal us. Oh. Oh crap, we're dead. Good thing Gao got spit out. Oh wait. Come on, Bismarck, actually, just so I can get
spells and small magics. Not like I'll use them, but just because it looks cool to have your skills filled out. It tells us, like, how much is left for the cursed shield. How much more must I suffer? Switch Bahamut out. Some speed. Let's get Ragnarok back in there. I just realized that Gao's Doom Timer has been different a couple times. Like sometimes it starts at 41, just now it started at 60. I wonder why it changes. Or maybe that's just how it is. It's just random. I don't know. Let's see. How many more? It's 88, so 12 more AP. Like four more battles minimum. This guy gives three, two of them gives five, and then Brachiosaurus gives us 10. Let's get speed up to 50. Or 49, whatever. And I'll switch him out to strength for the last level or two. Thank you. probably get 7 speed to 49, and then the rest can be strength. So 2 more levels, it makes 3 more for strength, so yeah. I'll be super buff. Super buff for sure. I forget if there's Esper that gives a +3 stat. That'd be pretty crazy. I don't think there is one, but would be nice for sure. Oops. Don't leave the forest. To grind. Yeah, I can only imagine how fast grinding in with just two characters would be, especially if one had a growth egg. Just trying to have 5 more characters left to level up. Ultima achieved. Okay, skip the rating for a little bit. I guess the rest could be rated. For Gao, it's +10, so that'll be 61, I think. Yeah, it's perfect. Let me just leave it on auto fight. Just Ultimas and. Phantom rushes. Honestly, at this point, Sabin could be the one that doesn't do anything. Because 2 Ultimas kills both. One more level of speed, and then 2 levels of strength will do, or yeah, strength will do for 7. So I decided to switch to those 2 just so I can get to the heal faster if I have to heal. Everything else stays the same. Oh no. Okay. As long as we don't all get pushed out, where should we go? Okay. Nah, dang. Okay, never mind. I thought it did Ultima on us. Nice. Alrighty. I think I was gonna do strength for the last few. No, it's not. I think she was gonna stay the same. Stamina. 5 level stamina brings me up to 50 something. Yeah, might be a little too much. Guess I get to 50-ish stamina, and then I'll do magic to finish it off. And again, he will just do strength for the rest of the time. I love when I fight those things and they actually die. Definitely love it better if they gave me the Celestia Triad. Gonna switch the gold or growth egg off. Give him back the Zephyr cloak. Give her the growth egg. Make sure I didn't take off the Celestia Triad on accident. That sucks. Perfect. Yeah, I definitely love when they surround us like this. It's probably the most optimal. One battle, pretty easy to fight. We get about 5,000 plus experience. Of course, the one with the growth egg gets 10,000, which is really nice. For stamina, I'll go ahead and switch it over to stamina. I'll give her magic for the rest. It'll be cool if Celeste can actually absorb Ultima with her runic attack. Though I'm not sure if that's a capability or not. Though I guess I could test it out by again having her in my party and then using runic while somebody else casts Ultima. That'd be pretty beefy if she could do that. She can switch over to magic now. I guess yeah, these two can keep doing what they're doing. Though I guess he should actually get some speed. He's pretty slow. Oh, he has stamina. Oh man. Let's give him speed first. Get one thing of speed and two things of stamina. I wonder if his stats don't matter as much, because it depends on his rage, right? But at the same time, if I don't use rage, which is why I made him into kind of a mage, I guess the stats do matter at that point. Plus he's wearing the cursed shield, so once that turns into a paladin shield or whatever, then his stats will definitely be a lot better than what they really are right now. teleport. Let's see. Sabin can start wearing the cursed stuff. Get the Zephyr cloak again. Both egg. Shield. Yeah, I dropped him all the way down. Yeah, it doesn't really matter if he does damage that much. Because Gao and, Gao and Realm are doing all the damage with Ultima. Oh, what's the stats now that I took off the, cursed? Ooh. Definitely bumped up a lot. Yeah, definitely. Maybe I should do 3 levels of stamina. Yeah, I should probably do 3 levels of stamina. Because speed isn't too much of an issue, because I can just add haste. See how much damage this does now that he's cursed. About, what, 1800 less? Yeah, not too big of a deal, because again, we are using Ultima here. Yeah, I remember my other save files actually grinded all the way to 99 with everybody, pretty much. I think there's a couple who were like 97 or something like that. And I'm like, why am I even doing this? It's no point. And so then I stopped. But yeah, this goes to show, if you have a goal and you really want to reach it, you can set it and just grind for it. I'm pretty sure I had probably 60... close to 60 hours on that particular save file. I'll probably have around 25, 29 by the end of this game, which is about average, I think. Even then, though, I could probably have already stopped around level 55, 60 per character, but I'm pretty much going all the way to nearly 70. I'm pretty sure I don't need that high of stats to fight the final encounter in this game, but it's happening regardless. Stamina, strength, and magic. Blocking everything over there. All gained a level.
I'm going to tuck away Mr. Sabin real quick.
Seven, 68. So everyone 68. So Realm, Gal. Have these two finish off their level real quick. So let's see how fast this is. With just two people. It's a little prelude. So much experience do I get? 4,400. I think I should have known that. And of course somebody gets 8,800 for the growth egg. Yeah, it's definitely 100% faster than doing all four at once. So that means if I face the surrounded one, then I should probably get 8,800. Oh Jesus! All right, let's see if I can actually do this one. So I'm not doing damage fast enough. I might eat it. I think I can just use Blizzard. I can just heal myself. Heal here. I have to all heal, but I think if I just keep blasting with Blizzard, it should be okay. Maybe four hits? It's cheating. But yeah, we are alive. Wow. Just a big chunk of XP, but not enough to level up. Unfortunately, not another Celestriad. Celestriad? I think that's actually how you pronounce it. I think this will level up Gal, but Rome still has probably one more battle before she can level up too. So I can go ahead and do that. Actually, they're both nice. Both gained it simultaneously. Alright, that means on to the next trio. It's gonna be Edgar, Shadow, and Celeste, I believe. Yep. The question is, am I gonna make Shadow a hybrid? Or will... is a good question. Soul Saber. Celestriad. Egg. Or will both these guys be kind of a hybrid? I don't know. I think Shadow should be a hybrid. So Especially for this grinding process. Otherwise, this could be very painful to just have only Celeste being the one that does the magic. So best case, let's have this man carry the curse shield. And just have him... Hold on, Zephyr Cloak. Wow, 52 impartisans. Crazy. Alright, so if he's also gonna do this... Well, that means I'm gonna have to learn, whatchamacallit, as well. Yeah, he's very low on stats. This is not good, actually. Zephyr Cloak. Okay. Guess we start off like this, just doing strength. Oh, she can't wear the circlet. Ulthale is just more for defense. I want those stat buffs, man. Crystal mail. I guess that would be the best. That's fine. Put people in the back. Alright. Grinding round two. I see how also when you do go into your airstrip, it moves it up a little bit. Let's put Celeste up top. Alright. Let's see how fast this will take. Or how slow it will take. I hope I can banish you. I guess he can just defend then. Yeah, I need my magic lady to get up in the levels really fast. Watch my heal. Need levels as fast as possible. For Celeste, I should say. Level obtained. Maybe I should actually, let's actually put the enhancer on because I won't be running out of MPA anytime soon. Because it only costs 1 MP per cast. So I should be able to just use the enhancer the whole time and should be at max capacity here. Don't wonder if it's enough. Oh yeah, it is. Because Edgar is not quite strong right now either. Alright, so it took about hour and 40-ish to grind up the other three. So let's try to do that here too. Alright, let's figure out a way to kill these guys. They did not die. It's gonna be quite painful this first few levels. If we keep getting levels like this, it'll be smooth sailing in no time. Oh, that did not kill him, for whatever reason. Dang, I'm that low on magic. Is there any other way to increase my magic? I don't think so. I think enhance is the only way, and I already have Sickle Lit on. Just gotta grind these levels out. Whoa. Did that cause a stop? I really need to be casting Ultima. Karaga only heals that much, like 1,000 something, because his magic's probably that low. Ouch! Holy crap. I think I should just leave him dead for a little bit, to be honest. So I can grind levels that much faster. Let's see here. Yeah, let's do that. Well, what's Celeste's status? 58 magic, so low. Even with all the buffed stuff. Mainly just the enhancer. I don't think I have anything else that's buffing magic right now. Yeah, I do not have. So I guess he can just throw. Throw stuff for now. Oh, I thought I went outside the forest for a second there. I do have Shuriken does more damage than me auto-attacking. It's kind of funny. I guess I can resurrect Edgar once Celeste gets to like 70 magic. It's like 4 more levels. Jeez. Killed here. Not from this, but for the next attack. Nope, we are safe. Sucks that I didn't turn that the other way. Oh, but it's okay. Excellent. This is how you power level. Yeah, imagine if I could do, I can make it so if there's an item that allows one person to not get any experience, and so the other characters would get all the experience,
That would be even better. Because, you know, I'll just pull out the stronger dudes. And just, have them sit in the party. Oh, jeez. It's not gonna kill me, but it's gonna be very close. That's scary. Whoa. I'm glad that dinosaur did not hit Celeste. So it would've been bad news bears. Yeah, I'm definitely gonna run out of Shurikens by the time I'm done here. I forgot where they even sold shurikens. That's bad. Two more levels. Give him a 60. Then I can start training his magic, probably. Oh, I don't want to fight this at all. I'm not going to do damage nearly fast enough. Get out of there. Is that 70? That's 70. Let's go ahead and res Mr. Edgar here. It's funny because he's actually the same level as Shadow now. I might get to a point where Celeste is going to be maxed out. See, the Diablos is actually an Esper that would give plus 100% HP to party, but don't really need him. Now, I believe the only way to get Diablos is you have to destroy all the elemental dragons, and then you can fight them. So that's definitely not something I can do anytime soon. Magic to go. Probably up to 80, to be honest. You know, right now, you know, Ultima does hit all nines, but how much does Fuma Shuriken can hurt?
It's about 1500 more damage, which isn't that necessary. Dead people. Yo, we're hella dead. What? Ah.
Dang it.
Would've been fine if they'd only cast one meteor, but just had to do two. Or if I should start, start using the one that gives auto shell. So I can't be taking heavy magic attacks like that. And shell reduces magic damage by half. I don't even know if I can beat this guy. I'm gonna pretend I can. Whoa. Maybe I might be able to. Looks like I'm going to. Yes. Too bad I didn't get another one of the Celestriads. Oopsie, 70. So it's 70 magic. I wonder if 60 is enough. If he's gonna be a, whatchamacallit, hybrid, I think 60 is enough. Do need stamina though. And then once Celeste hits 80 magic, I'm gonna switch her off too, and then Shadow can learn some high level magics. So you just have to keep throwing these Death Stars at everybody. I wonder if he can just auto attack and it'd be enough damage so that Celeste can finish it off.
And for sure, auto attacking should be enough. So if he's doing 6,000 with regular Shuriken, Fuma Shuriken should do around 8,000. I should probably put the egg on somebody else. Cloak. I guess Shadow can go ahead and take it. Answer is it cannot. Oh, because he's in the back row. I wonder if he can get a throwable item. Otherwise, I just put him in the front row, I guess, so he can auto attack. Let's see. I don't think he can take a throwable item. Nope. Guess you go in the front row, buddy. Yeah, Celeste is a whole 8 levels ahead of everybody. Which is good, I guess. It sucks though, Shadow can't really learn high level magics anytime soon. I just wish it didn't cost so much to learn. Wait, how much stamina do I have? 39. Let's get it to like 46, 47, 8. Maybe even 50, I don't know. Still need to do the Bahamut HP buff, but I guess I can do it towards the end of the grind for these characters. What's up? You're Muto? Or I'm Muto? Yeah, I'm just sitting here grinding for the end game. Try not to grind too much, because I could, you know, grind all the way to 99, but the goal isn't to 100% this game. The goal is to kind of beat it technically almost as fast as possible, per se, because I would do want to play Final Fantasy VII before the remake comes out. But other than that, I am just hanging in there. I think I've done like 6 hours of grinding so far. Not like consecutively, but between the sessions that I've been playing. Long and painful process, pretty much in any JRPG. And it's because they set experience growth to be exponential, and so you need a whole bunch of experience to really get all the XP you need to level up. I feel like that's like something you can't really get away from. Just grinding.
two more levels with magic. And then I'll switch Celeste off of gaining magic to, not sure what I'm gonna make her gain, but won't be magic for sure. Shadow have stamina is 43. Maybe that's good enough for stamina. Or maybe not, I don't know. After I finish grinding, I just have one more duo to grind with. It's gonna be Strago and Mog. After that, I finish grinding those two, I wanna go ahead and do the Mage's Tower real quick. It should be really quick because I have Ultima and like everyone's gonna be grinded enough to pretty much like easily one shot all enemies and then the boss at the top of the tower should be super easy too for the same reason. And then after I do that, I will probably stop for the day actually, but then when I come back, I'll finish the game off. I feel like the ending once I go to Kefka's tower should only take like maybe even less time because I could have one party set with Mog and Mog can wear the Moogle charm, which it makes it so you don't get any random encounters, which is hella good. Cause it's really annoying to have to fight random enemies when you don't want to. I think in the meantime, I'm going to try to learn Flare Ultima. There's actually a better place to grind AP points. Yeah, I actually did that already, but I don't feel like going back there just to learn a couple moves and come back, so you might as well just learn it as I'm here grinding for XP. Okay, what's Edgar's status? It's 58 strength. I think I'll try to. I'm not sure if I want to get to 70 with Edgar. He's kind of like a support guy too. But I guess he doesn't need to learn Ultima. Ah. Nice. I guess I'm gonna put you on Bahamut at the same time. So you're still gaining stat bonuses per level. I love how Interceptor kind of comes out randomly. Yeah, if it gets to a point where I'm actually done and I don't learn those two moves, Flare and Ultima, then I'll just go over to the other area and grind for it. Celeste is like almost. Well, she's 80. Switch her out. What is she... What should I get for her? I think it's just HP and speed. So let's put her on Bahamut while the dude's trying to learn something else.
Let's see.
Well, she's already at 5,000 HP. Maybe I shouldn't do that. Maybe I should do stamina. Let's do stamina. Stamina. What about Edgar? Still at 60. Guess that's fine. I really feel like I should just fly over to the AP area, just so I can get my move learned. Cause it's not too far away, if I remember correctly. I don't remember correctly. Yeah, it's where Miranda is. Miranda's in the bottom left corner continent. I think I should just go there real quick. Here. It shouldn't take that long. And I'm still grinding technically, it's just not as fast as that area with the dragons. Or not dragons, dinosaurs. It's right here. Because right here we get to face Cactuar and stuff. Here, we have to cast death on these guys. How much experience I get from this? Alright, 25. I think Edgar is ready to move on too. Let's go with speed. See, slow as crap. I think I might have to give Edgar Soul Saber. He's gonna run out of MP pretty quick. I guess I can give Celeste more strength for no reason. Or just keep boosting. Well, I don't need to boost magic anymore. Especially if Shadow needs to boost his magic pretty soon. Yeah, unfortunately I can't always get Cactars, which would make this part a lot easier. Alright, four more battles for Ragnarok, regardless. Maybe less now because of this. Four turns into two. Four turns into, it's done. Honestly, I can probably switch over to the magic now. And, oh, it's not done yet. Needs two more battles. I must have miscounted. Yeah, Edgar needs to take this growth egg pretty soon. Nice, I think we're done now. I think I just go back, cause Shadow's gonna be equipping this for a while after I finish with the Bahamut. I guess just so I'm not doing HP of the Bahamut too much, I'm gonna try to gain Flare right here, then I'll go back over. Speed 27, he's so slow. Whoops. Dang it. Why was that out on autocast? Burn Flare, okay. Alright, let's get out of here. Back to where we came from. Stamina's at 40. Let's give it a little bit more. It's 2 levels of stamina. 2 levels of speed, probably. Oh. Use Ultima now. Alright. Now, should we back to smooth sailing? Feeling this is not gonna do enough damage. Oh wow, did enough damage. I underestimated Ultima. Power of Ultima. I don't know what's happening, but I feel like Ultima's doing more damage when Shadow's using it than when Celeste was using it. Maybe I'm just imagining things. Because his magic should only be at, what, 39 maybe? It's pretty low. And he doesn't have the enhancer on. So yeah. Let me look. It's at 38. It's pretty low. Apparently not low enough though. Alright, once Shadow gets to level 60, I'm gonna switch the growth egg onto Edgar. But yeah, hopefully my curse shield turns into the paladin shield while I'm grinding here. It'll suck if I had to like do extra battles elsewhere. Alright, 42. Let me think here. Yeah, Edgar needs that speed. He's woefully slow. But, she also needs the speed. I don't really want to make, her gain strength. She doesn't need to. I guess we're in this conflict of interest type of place right now. Guess if I can get Edgar to like maybe like 35 speed, that'd probably be good enough. magic. Guess he gets a 50 magic. And that should be good enough for him as a support my magic caster. Well, the Edgar does need HP though. A little low there. Alright, let's go ahead and switch growth egg. Okay, so he actually has 36 speed. Which isn't too bad. Swap him to get some HP real quick. I think even Celeste can switch. I guess she can get one more thing of stamina. Can take some stamina as well. Switch to speed. I think one more level with Bahamut should give him Edgar enough HP now. See, they boosted up pretty quick actually. Just two levels ago, he was at like barely 4,000. And funny enough, like this battle is marginally more experience than the sandworms. back in the other place. It's just this battle right here is probably what makes it more, definitely more efficient. You just, you know, again, cast two Ultimas and they're dead. I'm at 50. Just need 3 more levels. That. Not sure what else I'm gonna get after. So we'll just wait and see. One more level in Bahamut is good to go, probably. Speed's at 37. I mean, do I even want any more stats elsewhere? I think I'm okay. Yeah, as long as I'm doing all nines with Ultima, it doesn't matter. Especially right here when it's split. I mean, it definitely doesn't matter. I must also remember that I am wearing the enhancer, so maybe I should actually think about getting more magic. Let me see something. So 3 levels gives him well, 50 or up to 50 magic. Pretty much I take off 7, I believe, for the enhancer. Or she can just equip the enhancer later on. I don't know. Guess we'll wait and see. Why? Why do you get to go first? Why do you cast Meteor on your first turn? Hey, Learn Flare. Alright.
Let's see. I wasn't gonna have him. Speed? Yeah, speed. He's woefully slow. Oh, but she's already doing speed. Stamina while you're waiting. What's her speed at? 37. If I can get her to either 43 or 45, doesn't really matter. Either or should do. So I do want to get her to maybe more magic. Just because the enhancers, like, enhancing her magic. This one's taking forever. What is that? Yep. Times one. Yeah, it's almost done anyways. Levels for 50 magic on the shadow. Anyone else is leveling quite nicely. Kinda wish I could fight a Brachiosaurus. I think I'm ready. I'm ready. I can probably put Shadow back in the back now. Back row. Since he's casted now. I'm pretty sure I have 99 Imp Artisans. I'm pretty sure I can probably throw some of these Imp Artisans. I wonder how much that would hurt. I should test it next. Let's see, speed. Gets two levels of speed. And one level of magic. Sounds good to me. For him, two levels of stamina and the rest speed. Sounds good. Man. Edgar is definitely like support status. Two levels of magic. Okay. Partisan, where are you? Let me just throw you at this guy. There he is. Yeah! Wow!
All nines. That's some good stuff. So if you run out of Shurikens, you have the Partisans. Anyways, I don't need to do any more. I can tell myself 2 speed and 1. I can even do 1 strength if I want to. I should probably do 1 magic though, because I don't really care about strength. If I was going to grind all the way to 100 or whatever, 99, however many levels you were allowed to level to, I would do strength later. But yeah, right now I can just keep doing this. Oh, finally. I haven't fought you in a long time. Right in the bunghole. Oh, wow. Hit pretty hard. I think I got him though. Oh, you're cheating. Hopefully he doesn't hit everybody. And he hit everybody. It's cheap. I think I should be able to kill him though with this last wave of attacks. Or just with that last attack. Dang, I still didn't get another Celestriad. It's always these last few levels that take a little longer than usual, or longer than getting to this point. I think if I remember correctly, alright, let me think here, I think I'm good with 40 stamina, right? I should probably switch over to speed. 4 levels of speed is 8 speed, yeah. And then plus the 7 that I get back from, Yeah, I guess I should take back the speed now. What is Celeste going to do, though? Don't want a jipper. Guess I could do strength. You know, I told myself I don't really care about strength. Guess it's strength. She can just have the last few levels of strength. Unless Shadow's almost done. He sees one more level, actually. Yeah. Do I want to learn Quick? You know, I don't even know what Quick does. How fast is it learning that? Times one. I guess we'll see what Quick does. Maybe Quick allows us to use two moves in one go. Wow, you saw how Celeste and Shadow's ATB went up fast, but then Edgar's is still like fairly slow. So yeah, definitely need some speed on him. Yeah, I feel like I'm gonna be able to finish this in one sitting. I still have two more characters to level up afterwards. Yeah. I think. I guess 5 levels of speed is fine. Get to 40 speed. Though again, it's not a good estimate because I have the curse shield on. Let me look at his stats without the curse shield. Goes up to 38. This doesn't even give strength. Oh well. Yeah, again, hopefully I finish this Paladin Shield, meaning Curse Shield. Take the curse off of it by using it for 256 fights. I really don't know how many fights I've been in so far with the shield equipped. Well over 150, probably. Because I started it with the second team. And, yeah. It's the third team. I'm pretty sure I probably will fight like at least 100 battles with this group right here. So it's either I'll finish before I put Edgar away, or I'll finish right at the start when I'm doing the other two. I'll probably put it on the Moogle. Kind of funny because Edgar's the one with the growth egg, but he's still like almost a level behind. But he's catching up fast, of course. It's as if he's playing or fighting, or he's like two people in one. Now think about it, I should probably put Edgar on defend, because he doesn't really need to do anything anymore. strength. 40, 40, 40. I was in that 40. Alright. So he's actually done. So actually, let's switch. Let's let her gain some more magic real quick. I think he already has quick, right? Yeah. So it doesn't matter. Dispelled the curse on the shield. What does it do though? I think it just gives a buttload of defense and magic defense. Alright. Cool. Well, I don't really need ribbon anymore. Well, yeah, I don't really need it anymore, but let's just keep it on. Just in case something weird happens. Let's actually look at his stats real quick before I do anything. I could technically bump his magic up if I wanted to, too. I should. Let's see. Yeah, let's do that. Try to finish off real quick, and then the other guys can jump in after. But yeah, fortunately the power of the shield does not like increase your stats, like your attributes. It just gives you more magic and physical defense. Yeah, I'll just take four more magic, that's fine. Two levels, right? We need one level. Nice. do I still want the speed? I think I still want the speed. 66, and then two more levels of magic gives me to 40. I feel like the magic for Edgar is more for healing rather than offensive. Yeah, I feel like I should pull out the next contestant on The Price is Right. Just so I have a means to level up fast. Because these guys are almost done too, so at least get the other guys ready. Done. Let's switch this to Yama. Two levels. Actually, I should probably give it to Shadow. Alright. Maybe I should just not pull out the next couple. Cause they're pretty much done. I don't know if Shadow and Edgar can really do this, but we'll see. Okay. Oops, I did not mean to defend. Alright, I guess I take it back. Because Shadow just does Ultima, Edgar just does drill, and then we're good to go. Yeah, two quick levels, we got this. Imagine about to do like solo, one character. Though I guess if I had a Vanish, like if it was a relic that casts Vanish automatically, maybe I have an easier chance of fighting these guys if I am by myself. I feel like I'm gonna run into the Bronchiosaurus pretty soon. That's just the two of us, and all hell's gonna break loose. There he is. Yeah, let's just try it. Actually, let's see what Quick does. Where is it? There it is. Sap Shadow be Quick. I feel like Quick allows me to do two things. Yes, it does. Quick allows me to do two actions in one turn.
Yeah.
Oof. That is excellent. Yeah, so quick allows you to do two moves back to back. Which is pretty interesting. Just so that I finish both characters at the same time, I'm going to switch who has the growth egg. I know fighting solo is probably horrific. Give me the Zephyr Cloak. Oops. I was gonna finish super fast. There should be one or two more battles, actually. One more for sure for Mr. Shadow, and then we'll see about Edgar. If we do fight the surrounding battle, then it is over. All right, I said you do one more battle for Edgar. Battle. Pretty sure I can just fight something over here. That mob better than one dragon or one T-Rex, but not better than two T-Rex. But it's like infinitely easier because you just one shot it with Ultima. What if I should fight out there first before I go into the forest? So Strago and Moogle are the last two. Everyone else is at 68, and I'm not gonna care about Mime or Yeti. I'm not bringing them into the final Kefka fight area. They're kind of like NPCs. They're kind of like, not necessarily made up characters, but characters that were created so that all the jobs could be fulfilled. Because if you notice, every single one of these have a specific job, more or less. Though I feel like Terra and Celeste kind of share a similar job. Though, I mean, Celeste has Runic, which absorbs one magic spell. While Terra has Trance, which boosts her magic powers. So I guess they kind of split their abilities so that they're both unique. Alright, it should be really quick, I feel. Especially compared to what we've been doing. Alright, let's see here. For sure, he's going to be a magic user. I feel like he should be the one that gets boosted quick. Because he needs to get his magic on. At the same time, maybe Moogle should be... It's a hard choice. I think he's just going to have I don't know about Genji Glove, actually. I guess Hyper Wrist and Guard. Where's the Hyper Wrist? And then you can do Magic. And you can do Strength. For a time, of course. Before I start doing this another and final grind session of this playthrough, I'm gonna take a break. I'm gonna hit a save real quick. And then let me go ahead and take a break. Go ahead and finish this grind session. Also, see, Strago is actually a lot of levels under Moogle. So, actually, let me try my theory. What if I fight out here first? Because I'm getting like 5k a pop, it looks like. Unless I fight this thing. Just hit it with Ultima! Should do a buttload of damage, even if I'm not maxed or high level magic. Well, I need a MP. Let's just use a tent. And yeah, I just realized that using a tent, whoever is the top of your party, or you know, the leader, the color of the tent is based off of the color of that character. I thought that was pretty cool. I didn't even see how much experience this I got from beating one of them. About to see how much we get for beating all of them. Alright, not too bad. I do want to fight the other thing, so maybe fighting in this is better. Maybe. I'm not sure. Yeah. A lot better out here. A lot safer, I should say. Why is Mago using this? Huh. I guess Gladius is that much stronger than everything else. Alright. Oh, I should give you the succulent. You should really get succulent too, actually. Succulent for power. Yeah, I did heal myself, okay. I need to see. Well, I don't think Moogle learned Ultima, did he? I think he did, actually. Yeah, let me just have him do Ultima too. What am I doing? It's so silly. Yeah. Give me one of these. Yeah, level 40 magic's pretty good. I mean, Who's Face Shadow was like using Ultima 2 when he was low level. For magic. So I don't see why not. Yeah, if I could finish this in like half an hour, that'd be pretty cool. There's only two of us now, so. Alright. Because out here, there's like no scare of getting wiped. That's pretty good experience for now. So I'm not afraid to venture into the dragon's forest or the dino forest. Oh, these guys are whipping my butt. Got another Reed Cloak. Alright. The thing is, we can't both be gaining magic, unfortunately. I don't know what also gives me magic. Oh, let me see here. I guess we can do up to level 50 strength, maybe? I haven't decided yet. I can fight those ball guys, that'd be perfect. Oh, I did not die. Thing that Mark could use. Probably get an earring on. So I'd like to be able to one-shot it. How much magic does Strago have? 62. Let's see if he can start whipping these dinosaurs' butts. I'm really glad I got those Celestriads. Should be perfect, and then you should do all nines, or at least very close to it. Or not. What? How much magic do I need? Okay, Strago died, but Mog will be still alive. That's what happens when you don't do your job. You're meteored. Oof. A lot of experience, but still not enough to level up, which is pretty funny. But yeah, imagine if I just do it by yourself. Just one character. He tries again. Just don't, whatchamacallit. Yep, still get meteored and we're good. Now, I wonder if our actual level is factored into how much damage we do. But definitely this should kill it because he's on one side, or they're on one side. Yep. For some reason, when we're split up like that, or when they are split up like that, it divides the damage in two for some reason. Doesn't make sense to me, but it is what it is. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I'm gonna be able to finish this in like half an hour. This is going a lot quicker. I'm starting to wonder why the first grind session took so long. Maybe it took the same amount of time, I just didn't realize. I don't know. I didn't really pay attention. Yeah, it would be pretty painful to grind with Gogo and Umaro, because one berserks, the other one mimes, so they pretty much be both berserking, I'm pretty sure. My struggle's already catching up here. Let's get him to like 80 magic probably. I'm not sure about Mog. I guess I can do 50 strength. So again, he's gonna be a support. So I guess I realize, I guess Mog is a bard and dancer class at the same time. While, there's no actual bard class. I don't think no one has bard abilities. All right, four more levels with Strago. Then I can switch him off. Probably for HP. Right, I could probably do it now if I wanted to, and let Mog gain some levels of magic. Yeah, this is so much faster. Having mages to just cast Ultimas. Really nice. I love Shargo's little, like, hair. Looks like grass. Man, I can only imagine if they, like, made it so we can get surrounded by Brachiosaurus. Ugh. Yeah, fighting one of them is already stupid. Only because they can wipe us with just one Ultima attack. Even then, the meteor is pretty strong, too. So, yeah. Two more levels for Strago. What's the Mog looking like? I think I wanted to get to 50 strength. Or at least 49, I guess, is good enough too. I Is that two levels? Nope, one more. It would be even better if I had two growth eggs. That'd be crazy. I'd be done with this in like 15 minutes. Yeah, just having two people that has reliable damage makes this a lot faster. I'm pretty sure that's why it's going by really quick compared to the other ones. I'm trying to think, the first set, who did I have? Terra, Locke, and Cyan. Yeah, Terra was the only one that can actually do heavy damage. Everyone else was kind of just there. Even then, I think I did a full party of four. Oh yeah, Sester was there too. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's why it was a four-man group. Oh, whoops. I was supposed to switch off, so Strago can gain HP instead of magic. I think he's at 80 now. Bahamuta. And then you can switch over to magic probably, right? I guess I can gain one more level. And I'll switch over to magic. Yeah, once Strago gets to 60, I'll switch over the growth egg to Mog.
Oh no!
I just realized I can actually do quick and then cast two ultimas. I don't know, does Mog know quick? I think I can find out right now. Yes, he does. Interesting. Because it'll just kill this mob like right away. I don't think Strago knows quick though. No, it's not as fast. I just get two turns though. Yeah, it's definitely not as fast. It's just having it auto cast Ultima. Oh, it didn't even kill him. What? What? Don't tell me it's weaker because it's like that. Alright. So let's switch you over to getting magic. So you can actually one shot, not one shot, but do pretty much all nines. Don't forget if there's a relic that allows us to act first per battle, regardless on if we get ambushed or whatever. I love how Mog just like dances around like that before each battle. Well, that's his class, Dancer. Okay. I just wanted to check the class of Mog, and it says Moogle. I also realized that they mixed Moogle into a Geomancer and Dancer at the same time. Alright, so we got that. I think I'll probably get some stamina, right? Yep, he has no stamina whatsoever. So I think the last levels are going to be stamina and then speed for this guy, Strago. Moogle. I guess Mach can get to level, or not level, but maybe a 55 magic. So three levels of, or however many levels I need. And then I can, do something else. So I'm already thinking ahead to my next playthrough, wherever and whenever that is. Whoa! That's new. That's also bad. I'm just gonna let it rock. If I die, I die. Two. Three and four. Either has 36,000 or 46,000. I hope it has 36,000. But it has 46,000. But I should be able to kill it. Yes. Okay, so it has 46,000. excuse me. So how much stamina I'm going for? Probably 40. So four more levels of this, and then two levels of speed, and then Strong will be done. Moogle. Kind of want to go for like 55 magic, but I think I was only three more levels of magic because I see the stamina is very low too. You could probably start with speed since Strong is on the stamina right now. Oh, I should probably heal, right? Oh, I already did. I still need to do HP too, jeez. Might have to only get 49 or something, 51 of magic for Mog, just so I can get HP and speed and stamina. Just so it's still comparable stats. Let's do one more level with Strago and then I'll switch the growth egg over. The growth egg, oh, there it is. Yeah, let me see Moogle status real quick. Magic's at 47. So let's do 49. So I have 49 and 49 magic and strength. And then I can do HP once or twice. Then do stamina and then speed. Yeah, technically I would have like 30 more levels worth of grinding if I wanted to like max out all the other stats, but again, it's not really necessary. You know, it kind of goes to show you that having dedicated roles is more important than being like good at both, I guess. Because again, if you go straight magic, you can like boost that magic stat all the way up. But if you hear like split like Mog is, you only do so much with both of the stats. Because you have to, again, save room for other stuff too. Even then, I didn't even boost that much of either or stat. Because say if I took like 10 or 12 points away from one and put them to the other, that's still what, 6 levels? Again, if I was able to have an Esper that gave even more stats, like plus 3, or crazy, it'd be plus 4, then yeah, I could definitely make super characters, like all the stats. I'm pretty sure at this trajectory, I should be able to get to all 9s for HP and MP. But, wait. Yeah, Mog's supposed to switch out. Honestly, I feel like I don't even need... Just do one level of Bahamut. How about that? Just one. Because... If I do level up, I will automatically already have enough for my 5,000 HP threshold. But yeah. tier 1 level. Let's switch to speed. Get 2 more levels of stamina, and I'll switch to speed. I can probably do... I'll just wait for Strago to get the 2 levels. I guess I'm about to get a level, so... we'll see in a second. If I could just get to like 40, low 40s for either stat, then that should be good. I'm pretty sure it's gonna get to a point where I have to switch out the growth egg again. Speed pretty high. Alright, so let's have Strago gain this next level and then I'll switch a Rue. So you get some speed up. While Mog gets some stamina up. Oh no. Oh yes. Disaster, I guess, is the scariest thing. It's pretty much this game's version of Bad Breath that the mob rolls usually do. I kind of realized there's no bomb roll in this game, right? Yeah, there is. It's in Daryl's too. But they didn't cast a Disaster or Bad Breath or anything like that. At least it didn't really affect me when I was down there. But this Brachiosaurus doing, oh no. Ah, that's a waste. Brachiosaurus doing Disaster. It is a disaster. Switcheroo time. Get the Cactar. You get the stamina. Reaching the home stretch. Four more levels for Strago. 4 will bring him to 40 speed, actually, so that's perfect. What about you? Stamina. 5 levels gives you to... Yeah, I think this is it. They just need to gain their appropriate levels and we're good to go. The stats are rounded out. And yeah, I think once Strago gets to 66, I'll switch over the egg. Let's Mog, like, somehow overcomes him. Which he will, actually. So it might just be whoever gets 67 first. Then the other person who's behind will get the egg. Man, I'm just imagining if I had two growth eggs, this would be even faster than it is right now. So pretty much, I guess the slower part would have been getting Ultima learned for everybody that I want to learn it anyways. Thinking back, probably like 8 of them should learn Ultima because they'll be like more supporty characters. Or they're just straight up mages. So I think we have Terra, Celeste, Realm, and Strago are straight up mages. At least that's how I view them. And then Mog, I decided to be... Oh, I guess it's more hybrid. So the those are the four main mages. Then the hybrid ones will be Setzer, Shadow, Mog, and Edward. Or Edgar. Edgar. That leaves Locke, Cyan, Sabin, and Gao. Oh, Gao would be another support. So I guess there would be 9 people that would learn Ultima off the bat. While the rest of them don't learn at all. So it's... Is that 4 characters that doesn't learn Ultima? Or do they, I don't know. I'm just, or maybe just 2 of them don't learn Ultima. Just Sabin and Locke. I think might be the only 2. Cause I would want Locke to have Mug. So that takes care of 1 relic slot, and then also Genji Glove, which allows him to equip 2, so he can mug twice for double the stealing rate. Sabin, you know, he just uses Phantom Dance all day. Then Cyan. Yeah, Cyan, I don't know. I guess he could do the Master Scroll and... Master Scroll and Gauntlet combo. So that actually makes so I was right the first time, 9 people who would get Ultima. Because those 3 I mentioned, Locke, Cyan, and Sabin, they will have their own like loadout that doesn't require using magic. Unless, you know, you're trying to support with healing or resurrection, like on the fly. Yeah. Alright, reaching the home stretch. It's 3 more levels apiece. Man, this is so much faster than what I was doing before. I should probably, like, well, if I'm my brain's still working by the next time I play this game, I can definitely think of better party compositions that allow for faster grinding. Though I also need to figure out if there's another Esper that allows for +2 magic, because I think that's also what made this a little slow. So I was like shuffling around Esper's a lot of menuing. Because here, all I'm doing is just healing and saving. It also helped that they were very deficient in these last stats, stamina and speed. So I can afford to have them just grind these particular stats. Right, Mog's about to get to level 67, so... Struggle, I guess, gets to take the egg back for his last 2 levels or so. And again, there's that RNG where I haven't really faced off against a Brachiosaurus. like 10 battles, give or take. Oh, they're still neck and neck. Interesting. Maybe I won't even need to trade out the egg. Well, I probably will still have to trade off the egg just for that last level or so. But otherwise, they're pretty neck and neck and, oh, here he is. Here we go. I mean, I should really be using Quick and Double Ultima. Now, I wonder if I could do a... no, I can't. I was going to say a Quick Loop, but I don't think so. I should probably research that again for the next time I'm going to be doing this feature. Okay, so that's... I'm quite sure how many Ultimas have... Oh, enough Ultimas have been cast. Right. I'm going to switch out that egg. Stretch here. Just need 35,000 experience, and then Mog is good to go, and then Strago should be just about done too. I don't know if I have. Nope, I don't. Is the Ultima queued up? That's what I'm still doing this, I can see if see if I can't kind of exploit the Quick mechanic. Oh, it's Quick broken. I'm reading this again. Thread about using Quick as an exploit, I guess. Apparently, you can use Quick. Wait, let's see. Quick allows for 5 Ultimas, first of all. Next off, if you're not using Ultima, enemies may actually live through some attacks. So, the difference between 2 and 5 is significant. Definitely 2 and 5 Ultimas, yeah. Oh, I see. Because the idea is, turn one, you cast Quick, and so that character can do Ultima twice. And then the rest of your party, which is 3 more characters, can cast Ultima apiece. So that's where the 5 comes from. But honestly, if everyone has Quick and everyone has Ultima, can't you just, like, yeah, just totally destroy everyone? Oh, apparently you can't use the Quick to, like, kind of infinitely cast. Because the idea is you would pretty much alternate between Quick and Ultima. You cast Quick, then cast Ultima, then cast Quick, then cast Ultima, so on and so forth. And because we're using the Celestriad, all spells cost only 1 mana. And so... yeah, you kind of just infinitely cast until it dies, pretty much. But I guess they took that out or something. Or maybe that's just never a thing. Oh, yes. Looks like they're both going to finish exactly at the same time. Which is perfect. Yep. I'll get extra stamina, which is fine. Okay. Let's finish this. Of course, granted, I always went to 68. I can easily went to like 75. Dumped like another 4 hours plus to grind. But again, this is more of a nostalgia playthrough, so I can get to Remake 7. I still have to play Final Fantasy 7 before Remake 7 comes out. I still have to play. Oh snap! Moogle didn't even level up. Dang it! Dang you, Moogle! I guess it's more because we didn't get the double. Oh, I guess I can fight out here. I didn't get the double encounter, so that's what happened. So, I'm pretty much done. Go ahead and save and end it for tonight.